you.
Oh, you son of a gun.
Ladies and gentlemen, John Wayne.
I wish you luck on this new show.
Well, Duke, thank you so much. Hey, I thought you was going to cut those off after True Grit.
I did. But I have to grow some more for another, well, I can't say hair picture.
Duke, I want you to know that it was the biggest thrill of my life to ride along beside you in my first movie. I just can't get over it.
Well, it took me a little while to get used to it, too, Glenn. No, but seriously, I want to congratulate you and wish you a lot of luck on this new show.
Well, thank you very much, Duke. It was my pleasure, and I sure hope you'll come back again.
Oh, well, I'll be happy to. It's kind of refreshing to walk out on a stage and not have to belt somebody or tear up a lot of furniture.
Well, believe me, it's a pleasure to show your gentle side. Ladies and gentlemen, a hand for the greatest guy in the world, Mr. John Wayne.
It's knowing that your door is always open and your path is free to walk. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Glen Campbell. Thank you. That makes me tend to leave my sleeping bag rolled up and stashed behind your couch. The people we have with us tonight are Miss Bobby Gentry and our own Pat Paulson. Of course, John Hartford's with us. Jack Burns is with us tonight. And special guest star, the very hip Smothers Brothers are here. Knowing I'm not shackled by forgotten words and bonds and the exchange that have dried upon some line that keeps you on the back roads by the rivers of my memory. It keeps you ever gentle on my mind. Go, buddy! Cowboy friend of mine, Mr. Dickie Smothers. Over here is another hard-riding, fast-shooting cowboy, Mr. Tommy Smothers. Bring Tommy up. Here he
thing. That's no way to talk about old paint.
Tommy, that's a hippopotamus.
What hippopotamus? He's a horse. He's the smartest horse in the whole world, and in fact, in the whole San Fernando Valley, including Dahunga. Aren't you, big fella?
That is a hippopotamus. It's big, and it's fat, and it's ugly.
Dick, I told you he was smart. Now, you keep talking like that, you're going to break his little heart.
He's the ugly. You're the ugliest.
Ooh. Big fella, he didn't mean it.
This is really ridiculous.
This is ridiculous. Glenn, listen, I apologize. This is your first show, and we're guests on your show. And Tommy,
oh, that's all right.
Tommy comes out and makes a fool of himself. Ooh, look at that. That's okay, Dick. Dick, you can insult me all you want, but just don't insult my hoss.
Now, look, I know something about hosses, and that ain't no Cartwright, fella.
Tommy, tell me this, honestly, would you expect to see something looking like this run in the Kentucky Derby?
Boy, sometimes it's pretty hard for me to even discuss anything with either one of you. You wouldn't know, you couldn't identify anything that didn't have wheels on it anyway.
No, come
on. Of course this wouldn't. This, he wasn't, he, of course he wouldn't run in the Kentucky Derby. He'd never run in a single race at all.
Right.
He wasn't bred that way.
Right.
Big fella's a jumper.
It's knowing that your door is always open and your path is free to walk. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Glen Campbell.
once in a lifetime. A man knows a moment, one wonderful moment, when fate takes his hand. And this is my moment, my once in a lifetime, where I can explore a new and exciting land. For once in my lifetime, I feel like a giant. I soar like an eagle, as though I had wings. For this is my moment, my destiny calls me. And though it may be just once in my lifetime, I am gonna do great things.
And I'd like to dedicate this to my mom and dad, because let's face it, if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be here doing this show, you know, and neither would my 10 brothers and sisters. You know, there's 12 kids in the family altogether, and that's no bull. It's straight, legit, right off the top of the head. There's 12 kids in the family. Dad said they come cheaper by the dozen. You know. I guess Mom was hard of hearing, you know, and down on the farm, there's not too much activity. And he said, you want to go to bed or what? She says, what? But I'd like to dedicate this to them. Daddy kind of likes bluegrass music a little bit. I'll move around over here. And I do too. Who don't like bluegrass music? This was written by a good friend of mine, Merle Travis. That's blues bluegrass. Listen to that sound. You take a K, a E, and then you add an N and a T. A U and a CKY. And that spells Kentucky. And it means paradise. You take a chicken and you kill it and you put it in a skillet and you fry it up a golden brown. That's southern cooking. And it's a mighty nice. Well, it don't cover a lot when you look on a map. But I wouldn't study no geography when it's sitting in my mammy's lap. You take a K and an E, N and a T, a U and a CKY. That spells Kentucky. And it means paradise. It don't cover a lot, yeah, or when you look on a map.
Okay. Now,
camera's on?
Yes, now, right now.
Sock it to the bum. But take a little bitty town.
You take it.
You like the mayor of a little bitty town.
Square little town to make it go round. Squares make the world go round.
Take it, Tom.
Tom, go, Tom. Attaboy. Now, kick out of state.
Kick out of state. He likes the governor of the state.
Square little man that makes it go round. Squares make the world go round. Hey, squares make the world go round. It sounds profane and sounds profound. But government things can't be measured by hipsters wear their rubber soled shoes.
Bum, 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 bum,
bum. I am a lineman for the county. I drive the main road, searching in the sun for another overload. I hear you singing in the wire, I can hear you through the wire, and the Wichita line is still on the line. I know I need a small vacation, but it don't look like rain. And if it snows, that stretch down south won't ever stand. major tall lineman is still on the line. Still on the line.
Thank you all, Bush.
By the time I get to Phoenix, she'll be rising. She'll find the note I left hanging on her door. She'll laugh when she reads the part that says I'm leaving, 'cause I've left that girl so many times before. Stop at lunch and give me a call. But she'll just hear that phone keep on ringing off the wall. That's all. Time I make Oklahoma, she'll be sleeping. She'll turn softly and call my name out low. Oh, and she'll cry just to time and time I've tried to tell her so. She just didn't know I would really go. No, she didn't know I'd go.
Yeah, before fascinating beast that beats within my battered breast. Burning in the devil and not allowing any rest. The thunder in my mind reflects the storm within my heart. A blasting, blaring sound that tears my soul apart. If this is love, who needs it? There's a tender, tempting feeling that is glowing in my mind. Soothing and caressing, a part of me that's blind. A warming worm that's mellowing and eating my resolve. Changing and challenging my cold heart to dissolve. If this is love, oh yes, I want it. This is the love I give to you alone.
One for the money, a two for the show, a three to get ready. Now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything, but lay hold for my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slender my name all over the place. Do anything you want to do, but honey, lay hold for them shoe. Now don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything, but lay hold for them blue suede shoe.